To be a champion at District 51 humorous speech contest is definitely not an easy thing. Looking at all the talent we have here in District 51. But our past district champion at once Toastmaster Bronze, beaten leader, Stephen Fernando, did it. Not once, but three times. Correction, four times. 2004, 2005, 2006 in a row. And that definitely was a very magnificent feat. But after that, 2007 onwards, he says, give others a chance. Now in 2004, he represented District 51 in Reno, USA for the International Speech Contest. And he was crowned as the first runner-up. In 2010, he went to the USA again for the contest, another contest. This time, his excuse is, give the younger ones a chance. This evening, we are indeed very fortunate that we have Stephen Fernando here today to share with us all his tips on how to be a champion in humorous speech and all the speech contests. This is valuable and very, very expensive sharing. And this comes with a price, he says. It's not free, it comes with a price. He wants to know if somebody can sponsor him a new car or not. First, we'll be screening his winning speech in 2006 at the KL Semi-annual convention at the Legend Hotel. Can you all remember that? Anybody remember? Luckily, if you can remember, you must be very, very old. In 2006, at the Legend Hotel, Stephen Fernando won the contest for District 51. And the contest speech is called Innocent Miscommunication. So ladies and gentlemen, let's hear the speech first, and later Stephen will come up here to reveal all his secrets. So ladies and gentlemen, Stephen Fernando, Innocent Miscommunication. The star is still here, he'll come up and share with us. Stephen Fernando.
Thank you, Bernard. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You saw half, the other half you come next week, lah. That is called innocent miscommunication. And the contest chair is my cousin, she's here, lah. Su Ning, where is Su Ning? She's the contest chair, so nice. Because in Toastmaster, we got a lot of cousins. Right, so now I got 10 minutes. Where's the time? 10 minutes. 10 minutes only to share with you. In 2001, I took part in the humor contest in Kuching, you know, not place. In 2002, I took part in humor contest Singapore, second place. Like, first place was Ong Tee Kien. Then 2001. You know him, huh? Is it Ong Tee Kien? You mean the name change? Sorry, Mr. Ong. Then 2004, 2005, 2006, and 2008. So I tell you today what to do. But actually, just now I was listening to the speakers. All are very good. They all know what it is. But today, so I share with you my personal, how I do humor. I tell you, for me, humor is very simple. If you ask me, if you're a person never done a humor speech, you ask me how it is. Am I standing normal?
No.
You know what? Just now I was standing, my shoe sole came out. That part of it is there, but not hiding. Sorry. So now I'm like, you know, they call it paika. So what happened, if you want to do a humor speech, normally I do this. And you got to do, if you want, you list down all the humorous, embarrassing disappointments in your life. All of us got them. The only problem with you and me is, you all are very shy. I tell it. But of course, one thing very important for humorous speech, you must have the face for it. Unfortunately, you all look very nice, so you can't win. so always my wife tell the neighbor, you know, she say he wants some humor contest. So my neighbor said, "Wow, Uncle Steven so clever." She said, "No, you look at him already, you laugh." So unfortunately for you all, that's a disadvantage. I mean, true, isn't it? I accept that. That's why I make fun of myself. And then people listen and they laugh. And then the judges feel sorry, you know. They say, "Thank God my brother or me not like that one." If I have one of like him in the house, how? So then they give points. So all my speeches, and that's what I would suggest you do, you talk about your embarrassing moments in life. And then you sure win. So like this one all is all very true, you know. Like this speech is about when I was 60 years old, then I go for functions, you know, people like to ask, "Uncle, how old are you?" 60, still working? Then I say, "Yes." They say, "Ayo, why you have to work, uncle?" 60, Then I say, "I'm writer." Oh, they respect, you know. Because normally those who write books until 80, 90 die also write one. So I say, "I'm a writer, yeah." So I'm still writing the same book. So I don't know the title also. The title is called, I have it on my internet, you know, it's called Falling from the Sky. So what we do is, we talk about our own experiences. If you ask me today how to prepare a humorous speech, I'll tell you, number one, you write down all some funny experiences in your life. Yeah? Anything that happened. This year, I'm taking part in the division contest next week, you know. In my club, I was the champion. I'm the MIHRN champion. Only one contested me. That is called innocent miscommunication. Because they had a contest in my club. Then distinguished Toastmaster, Francis was the chief judge. He brought about 22 role players, no contestant. So I came in, Francis said, "Okay, Fernando, you are the winner. Thank you." Then I went home, my wife said, "How was the contest? You won?" I said, "I won." She said, "You always win." I said, "Well, you know." She never asked me how many contestants. Innocent miscommunication. That's why you take a simple concept. So this year, my speech, just to share with you. Last year, you know, I go jogging in Kelana Jaya, the park, you know, in the morning. And I'll tell you straight up, I'm a very scared fellow, you know. That's why I got humor. I'm very scared. I always believe, if I knock somebody on the road, they'll call me to fight. I'll always ask him when. He said, "Maulawan," I say, "Bila." He says, sekarang tarah senang." It's part of my speech. I say, I got two other fights. Satu dekat Kepong, satu dekat Taman Sari. What about next week? Because I'm quite full. So, this is a true story. I was jogging in the morning with my friend. This friend was quite a tough guy, you know, Chinaman with mustache. You know, Chinaman mustache very fierce one, huh? Indian man mustache quite normal. So Chinaman mustache. Then he saw the normal guy who goes around snatching handbags from the people who walk in the park. He said, "That fellow," he chased him, you know. He ran after him. I ran the opposite way. Then he came back, lucky the guy ran off. He said, "Fernando, why you never follow me?" I said, "You don't know, I'm your backup, you know." Backup means stay back, run opposite direction. He said, "You are really coward." So my title of speech this year is, "I am a coward." I talk about that, I make it like that. Then you go and talk, people say, "You are a coward, thank God I'm not like that." They feel good. So you take some simple life experience, and then you put it in a speech. But very important, you must have a message. So like, "I'm a coward," my message is, it takes all kinds to make the world. You must have coward. If no coward, you can't recognize the hero. you tie up like that. Just like innocent miscommunication is good, but we always say that we may communicate. If you don't understand, it's the person who is speaking or communicating fault. Actually, no. Like today I'm talking to you, if you don't understand, not my fault, you know. Because in your mind you got other things, you know. What time is Bota going to finish? Oh, who will win? Dennis or Pam? So, not my fault if you don't understand. So they call it innocent miscommunication. Then finally, I must tell you, when we do this humorous speech, don't make fun of mother-in-laws. Not true, you know. I remember I went to Kuching once, there were 7 contestants, 4 of them make fun of mother-in-law. Everybody laughed, but none of them won, you know. You know why? Four of the judges, I think, were ladies. Don't make fun of mother-in-law. Don't make fun of mother-in-law. Don't make fun of wife, children. Or, I mean, if you make fun, must be in a way where we are the ones in the receiving end. So finally, I'd like to tell you that in humorous speech, a lot of animation and vocal variety needed. Animation. For that one, I see most of you are Chinese, but you got to learn it from Indians. Like Mr. Sivalingam, Mr. Singh, we all are quite natural. You know? That's why most, Mr. S.K. Ratnam, that's why we win. That's why nowadays when I talk to my wife, also a lot of animation is practicing. She said, why you never buy the bread? You mean bread? White bread or brown bread? Sick bread. Like that. That's practicing for the speech. And you must have vocal variety. Okay? Any questions? None. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more night. Stephen Fernando. Thank you very much, Stephen.